FP Qazi Ahmad as 200 armed men surrounded their house on a hot August night in 2005, Nazo Tahario and her sisters grabbed their Kalashnikov and puny stock of ammunition and climbed to the roof. The gunfight which followed earned her the moniker Pakistan's toughest woman, and became the subject of a film which has been entered in next year's Academy Awards, vying for glory alongside heavy hitters such as Angelina Jolie's First They Killed My Father and Joaquin Trier's Thelma. A world away from Hollywood's red carpet, at the ancestral home Tahario fought for in Pakistan's rural Sindh province, she described the night which could lead to Oscar glory. "I will kill them or die here but never retreat," Tahario, now in her late 40s, recalled saying as assailants attacked her home. Her husband begged her to stand down but she refused, facing down her own relatives, who were armed and had long sought to take her family's property after her father died leaving no male heir, she said. Her grandfather had several wives, and the male heirs in other branches of his family were laying claim to her inheritance. But her family had defied rural Pakistani cultural norms of the time to educate their daughters and teach them they were as good as boys, and the sisters were willing to give their lives to prove it. From their position on the roof, their tiny army, the three sisters, Tahario's husband and some loyal friends and neighbors, held off the onslaught, with household staff making daring runs for more ammunition until daylight broke. A five-year legal battle over the land eventually saw her foes pay ₹500,000, $4,800, in compensation and offer a public apology, an act of utmost disgrace in rural Pakistan. Born in a conservative feudal family, Tahario was entitled to learn the Quran at home, and that was all. She persuaded her father to allow her and her sisters to study English, which paved the way for her to gain her Bachelor of Arts in Economics at Sindh University, where she could study at home and appear in public only for the exams. But the modern justice system has made few inroads into rural Sindh, where little has changed for centuries in a society dominated by feudalism, and the bloody years-long fight over her family's land threatened many times to derail her progress. It kept intensifying. 5-6 murders took place and in 1992 my brother was also murdered, she explained. When her father died that same year, the women who visited to pay condolences taunted her mother and sisters that their family line had ended. But Tahario's determination, particularly her defiant stand over her family's property years later, slowly turned the tide. Soon neighbors began to speak of her as waitery, a new feminine version of the male honorific waitera meaning something akin to a feudal lady. "She has become such a huge tree spreading soothing shade to the people around her," commented Zulfikar Tahario as his wife, draped in a traditional printed Sindhi shawl, rocked gently on a nearby swing bed in their sparse drawing room, hung with more guns. In 2013 Tahario's story came to the attention of a British-born Pakistani filmmaker, Sarmad Masood.